Welcome to a new video that is MCQs on microscope stain and staining techniques. Okay, and this is the first video of this series of videos on microscope stain and staining techniques. So the first question is, the maximum resolution of a light microscope is 0.2 nanometer or 0.1 nanometer or 0.2 millimeter or 0.2 micrometer. And the right answer is option D, that is 0.2 micrometer. So the maximum resolution of a light microscope is 0.2 micrometer. So the next question is, the first microscope was invented by Leeuwenhoek, Hooke, that means Robert Hooke, or F. Janssen and Z. Janssen, or Sladen. And the right answer is option C, that is Janssen and Janssen. So the first microscope was invented by Janssen and Janssen. And one thing we have to remember, that this the first microscope was invented by Dutch spectacle maker Hans and Jacques Janssen. They designed a device that magnified objects using two lenses, creating a compound microscope. So they are the first inventor of the microscope. And Robert Hooke and Antony van Leeuwenhoek were among the first scientists to use the microscope for various studies, like studies of live cells. Okay, so move on to the next question, that is, father of microscopy and microbiology is Theophrastus or Janssen or Leeuwenhoek or Hooker. Okay, so the right answer is option C, that is Leeuwenhoek. So the father of microscopy and microbiology is Leeuwenhoek. So move on to the next question. So which of the following is not a type of light microscope? And the options are bright field microscope, transmission electron microscope, that is TEM, or fluorescence microscope or fluorescent microscope, or phase contrast microscope. So the right answer is option B, that is transmission electron microscope is not a type of light microscope. Okay, so the next question is, when light passes from a medium of a greater refractive index, light slow down and bend away from the normal, or light slow down and bend towards the normal, or speeds or light speed ups and bends toward the normal, or light speeds up and bend away from the normal. And the right answer is option B, that is light slow down and bends towards the normal. So when light passes from a medium of a greater refractive index, light slows down and bends towards the normal. Okay, so dekhte hain next question kya hai. So next question is, which of the following microscopy does not require any pre-treatment procedure before imaging? And the options are TEM, that means transmission electron microscope, or SEM, or confocal microscope, or optical microscope. It is the scanning electron microscope. So the right answer is option D, that is optical microscope. So following, so optical microscope does not require any pre-treatment procedure before imaging. But other than this, that is TEM, SEM, and confocal, they require a pre-treatment procedure of the object. Okay, so move on to the next. The first electromagnetic lens was developed by which scientist? Options are Antony van Leeuwenhoek, Robert Hooke, Hans Busch, or Ernest Ruska. And the right answer is option C, Hans Busch. So move on to the next. Lens with a short focal length will magnify an object, or will minimize an object, or object will appear of the same size or object will appear blur? And the right answer is option A, that is object will magnify, it will magnify an object. So lens with a short focal length will magnify an object. Okay, so move on to the next question. Microscopes having two eyepieces are called multiocular microscope or uniocular microscope or binocular microscope or none of these. And the right answer is option C, that is binocular microscope. So microscopes having two eyepieces are called binocular microscope. Okay, so the next question is, Ernest Abbey developed an equation for resolution in 1880s, 1970s, or 1890s, or 1930s. And the right answer is option A, that is 1870s. So Ernest Abbey developed an equation for resolution in 1870s. Okay, so next question kya hai dekhte hai hum. So next question is, which of the following is or are authentic about compound microscope? And the options are, light microscope uses glass lenses to bend and focus light rays and produce enlarged image. And option B is, resolution of microscope is determined by numerical aperture and wavelength of light used. And option C is, maximum resolution by compound microscope is 0.2 micron. Or the option D, all of the above are correct about compound microscope. And the right answer is option D, that is all of the above are correct about compound microscope. So all options are about the compound microscope is correct. So move on to the next. Microorganisms are fixed and stained before observed in bright field microscope because they are colorless, because microorganisms grow well when stained, or option C, because microorganisms survive longer when stained, or because microorganisms get killed by staining. And the right answer is option A, that is because they are colorless. So microorganisms are fixed and stained before observed in bright field microscope because they are colorless. Okay, so move on to the next question. That is, transmission electron microscope has great resolution compared to compound microscope because light microscope is determined to electron, because TEM uses electron beam instead of visible light, or option C, because microbes prefer TEM over light microscope to get visualized or cannot be predicted. And the right answer is option B, that is because TEM uses electron beam instead of visible light. So transmission electron microscope has greater resolution compared to compound microscope because TEM uses electron beam instead of visible light. Okay, so next question is, numerical aperture is an angular theta of angle of the cone of the light that enters lens from a specimen. So which is the cone? So what is the cone? So that is 2/3 or 1/2 or 3/4 or 1/3. And the right answer is option B, that is half, 1/2. So now one thing we have to know, that is what is numerical aperture. So numerical aperture here we can see, this is the slide where object is present here and this is the objective lens. So here a cone is formed here. So this cone is called the theta, and the numerical aperture is n sine theta. So here n is the refractive index of this medium. Here is the air, and alpha means this cone formed between this objective lens and this slide or object. Okay, so here this is the numerical aperture. So based on this numerical aperture, the light get entered into the objective lens higher or lower. Okay, so this is the role of numerical aperture. So move on to the next question, that is, which microscope is used to observe living unstained cell by simple changing the way in which they are illuminated? And the options are bright field microscope, electron microscope, dark field microscope, or fluorescent microscope. And the right answer is option C, that is dark field microscope. So the dark field microscope is used to observe living unstained cells by simple changing the way in which they are illuminated. Okay, so the next one is, unpigmented living cells that are not clearly visible in the bright field microscope can be viewed under dark field microscope, phase contrast microscope, or TEM or fluorescent microscope. And the right answer is option B, that is phase contrast microscope. So unpigmented living cells that are not clearly visible in the bright field microscope can be viewed under phase contrast microscope. Okay, so move on to the next question, that is, the problem of murky and fuzzy image produced by light microscope is solved by the development of transmission electron microscope, or scanning electron microscope, or confocal scanning laser microscope, or all of these? And the right answer is option C, that is confocal scanning laser microscope. So the problem of murky and fuzzy image produced by light microscope is solved by the development of confocal scanning laser microscope. So dekhte next question kya hai. So next question hai, confocal microscope uses to illuminate the specimen by visible light, or electron beam, or laser beam, or infrared rays? And the right answer is option C, that is laser beam. So confocal microscope uses laser beam to illuminate the specimen. So the next question is, the laser beam used in confocal microscope is fluorescently stained, or reached the farthest areas of the specimen, or doesn't work on stained specimen, or none of the above? And the right answer is option A, that is fluorescently stained. Okay, so the laser beam used in confocal microscope is fluorescently stained. So the last question of this video is, inclusion bodies and microbial mobility can be best studied under which light microscope? And the options are phase contrast microscope, fluorescent microscope, dark field microscope, or compound microscope. And the right answer is option A, that is phase contrast microscope. So inclusion bodies and microbial mobility can be best studied under phase contrast microscope. Okay, so these are the all 20 questions of this part 1 video. So thank you for watching this video.